The old country school is dying out. It's on its last legs. I can show you here on this chart. These black schoolhouses here are the open schoolhouses. That is, they're the ones that are now operating and trying to teach the children some of the basic principles of education. These crosses are the closed schools. And you see how many there are of them. In the whole Madison County, there are only 33 schools open today. And last year, there were 5 closed, and there will be more closed this year. Now, there was, at one time, 100 schools in Madison County. Do you get the picture? Is it getting any better? Constantly getting worse. And it's going to keep on getting worse. Because all of these people that have closed their schools and sent their children to town, you can't find one of them that's willing to take their children back out of town and put them in those closed schools. Not one.
Well, is this the solution right here that you're presenting? Is it the Winterset?
This is the Winterset plan of consolidation. There may be bugs in it. That is, I mean, it may have flaws, but it's a plan. It's a step forward. And I think that it's going to be a mighty big improvement over our present system. It is going to be a monumental step forward. And it's going to be something that we can be proud of all the rest of our lives, that we did help to organize it. And it's going to be something that we can depend on from year to year for the next 50 or 100 years. Because it's a big organization with 219 square miles of area, $11 million of assessed valuation, and that's enough territory to support a good school system.
Then this is the plan you like, is that it?
I do.
Right here. You sure others like it?
I hope they do. If they really got the information that they should have and understand it, I'm sure that they will like it. If there are anything in there that we'd like to change, it's not wise to say, no, I won't have anything to do with it. The thing to do is to go ahead with it and change it as time goes by. We'll have a board of directors elected by all the people of this district, and they can change anything that seems to be inequitable.
Let's ask Mr. Speerah what he thinks about it. That'd be all right?
Sure.
Mr. Speerah, you like that?
Mr. Holland is talking about a school system that he went to 60 years ago. The school system that my little girl goes to today is as much different from that old school system that he is speaking of as the atomic age is over the old ox cart.
That's right.
Amen.
I'm opposed to the closing of the rural elementary schools of Madison County for 3 principal reasons. First of all, let's look at the quality of our schools. And you listen to me, Mr. Holland, please.
Talk just a little bit louder, will you, Karen?
Under our system of schools, I will say as to their quality, I will use a statement that was made by one of the members of the State Department of Education after they had visited our school. The statement is that Madison County has one of the finest, if not the very finest, rural elementary school systems in the state of Iowa. Why did they make that statement? They had a reason for it. Of course, they based their opinion on the quality of our buildings, the material that we had in the buildings to work with, the equipment, the ability of our teachers, the money that was available to operate our present schools, and above all, the opportunity that that small group of children had where a teacher could give them individual, specialized attention that you'll never get in a school of 1,000 or more enrollment as the proposed plan will have.
You don't like Holland's plan?
I'm not opposed to his plan. I am opposed to the closing of junking of the best elementary school system, and they're one of the best elementary school systems in the state of Iowa. Secondly, I'm opposed to this consolidation plan from a transportation standpoint. At present, we have no transportation problem under our present system. Any school that is now open or any school that should be open, youngsters are all within average walking distance. Of course, there's days when weather's bad or the youngster's small, that the parent provides transportation. It's a privilege, I feel, for a parent to do that much for his own flesh and blood. I certainly will. Under this proposed plan, many of these youngsters will still walk a considerable distance until they meet the bus. There, they'll stand out in all kinds of weather, get on the bus and ride 15 to 25 miles uphill and downhill, snow, ice, rain, sleet, low zero temperatures, and finally they're going to get to the central school in Winterset. I would like to ask you people right here tonight, how many of you would like to take that kind of a bus ride to and from work every day? How many of you are doing it or would be willing to do it? Yet there is a certain group of planners that propose to make my little children do that very thing. If you ask my opinion about it, it's a pretty raw deal. On a third point, why I'm opposed to the closing of these elementary schools is from a financial standpoint. Let's use a chart for that. Under our present plan of operating our elementary schools, we have an evaluation of approximately $9 million. We have 700 pupils. Now let's break down the cost that we have to operate these schools to an individual basis. Every man, woman, and child in the Madison County pays $50.53 toward operation of our schools under the present system. Under the proposed plan, the consolidated plan, and I am using my figures based on the figures that were given to me by the Winterset School Board, the cost to educate those same children in town will be $67.70 per person. That's per capita. Now, Winterset always has made the remark that the rural people are getting a free ride in education. There is the valuation of the property in Winterset, $2,600,000. This practically the same amount of pupils as the rural area. Yet, they are operating their schools on a per capita cost of $35.19. How does that compare with the rural area up here? Are we getting a free ride? Under the proposed plan, we rural people will start paying the cost of the town education. The town cost will drop to a $17 per capita rate. Now that sounds very good for a town person, doesn't it? But that is only the beginning, and here's the stinger. There's a $1 million building program considered. Take that into consideration. Folks, those are just a few of the problems that we are confronting us under this consolidated plan. And remember, in the light of the fact that they are going to abolish, they're going to jump one of the best educational systems in the state of Iowa.
You fellas think they're reciting fact or fiction here?
Now, you're all from rural areas. You're all farmers. Do you all feel that this one-room school you have is really as good as Speerah says it is?
No.
Let's hear about it.
It can be. Let me tell you something as we did in our rural district. 5 years ago, the district that I represent...
You interrupted the lady, you know. Go ahead.
Pardon me. The district that I represent was in the same category as the district that Mr. Holland represents. Our school was run down. What did our school do? We appropriated a little money. I am secretary of that school board, and I know just about how much it cost to build that school up into one of the best schools in the state of Iowa.
Mrs.
Every
Mary.
School could do the same if they just spent a little money for it.
Mrs. Mary, stand up and answer quick, will you?
I don't have an answer for him on his particular school, but out in our school, most anything is better than that school. It's improved a lot in the last 5 years, but it's got a long way to go yet.
Amen.
What's wrong with it?
Well, they haven't had good teachers for a while. We've got a pretty good teacher right now, but they didn't used to have any equipment. They didn't. Their maps were 25 years old in that school.
Sort of studying history, is that it?
No, long time back. and they didn't even have a globe. The teacher still has no desktop. Still has none.
I feel
that
sorry for those
children.
I do
too.
I feel that it was the place of the board to do better by their own children than that.
We haven't been down there very long. It's improved a lot since we've been there. But it's got a long way to go yet. The only thing that worries me is transportation.
Joe, you're smiling. What's
wrong? Well, I want to ask Kenneth one question, and that is, how does he account for all these schools being closed? There's more being closed every day. Now, just what is the outcome of these rural schools?
Well,